Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ross Patterson Revolution! Brought to you by GhostBed.com!
We've been recording extra shows because we were going on the Drinkin' Bros podcast cruise, and we're
little doing lady it. Is going to Stowaway.
Yeah,
I did not pay for a ticket, but I will be in a suitcase, right, with the Listerine that we've emptied out and put vodka in. Don't bust us.
Don't need it on a cruise. Plenty of booze.
Why do Plenty people always do that on cruises then? I know my friends went a long time ago and they like had to find all these different containers to put vodka in.
Booze, yeah. Well,
is it expensive? Are my friends ghetto?
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
There's a yes for both of those, right? It depends on what you're getting on the cruise, booze-wise.
Okay.
But no, I wouldn't say the prices are any that much different.
Are they going to have a mid-range thick red?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You're
so
good.
So no need to...
You can drink that in the middle of the afternoon on the cruise?
No. I might go pina.
Really?
Colata.
Really?
Ah. No, I have to do one just because that would be funny.
You know I love them, right?
I know you do because you love a sweet, fruity umbrella drink. When we went to the Bahamas, every
There's
time they would bring the drinks out, it would be like I would get a glass of wine or vodka soda, something,
and
he would have the big in the pineapple with all the things, and they'd try to hand his drink to me always, because that's usually what you would, like, in your mind, we're still old school.
Should be for ladies, maybe.
They're still old school. They're still trapped in the past.
Yeah. Yep.
What they don't know about Mr. Ross is
There's a good reason for it, right?
Yeah, that you like super sweet drinks.
No.
There's no other.
I don't like to wait. So obviously you have one drink, you start partying, you're like, oh man, I don't want to keep going back to the bar. So I'll get a double shot, maybe triple in there. The best thing to cut that with, so it's you're just not drinking straight liquor, obviously, is a pina.
Mm-hmm.
It's some form of colada like that, Long Island iced tea. You need it cut with something if you want something stronger, right?
Right.
Because midday partying for me, like, I'm one of the best there is. Some say I was created for it. But I don't want to keep going back and forth to the bar. I would rather let's just knock it out with one shot here, okay?
Sure.
So give me a peener. And that's going to cut those three shots of rum real nice for the doctor.
Right. So.
And they love it. The waiters love it when I say, give me a peener.
Yeah.
I need another peener. One more peener, sir.
The most annoying person to bartenders.
And even in the Bahamas, I have a tradition where I usually call some, after my second or third, I call them hombres or señores. And that's a totally different country. But I feel like those
They definitely don't speak Spanish there.
Are universal terms, though, Jesse. So when I get my peeners from my hombres, that's why I'm doing it.
That's
why I'm doing that.
You know I like to stay on brand.
Yo, yeah. Yo,
so
yeah.
I will, I think, have to drink a red.
Probably.
Because, you know, that's what the people are going to want
from
me, you know? If I show up, you know, at the cruise talking to some listeners, some drinking bros, and I don't have a thick red in my hand, they're going to be confused.
Real confused.
So, again, I'm doing it for them.
Yep.
I may have a pina.
Yeah.
Not a peener.
Okay.
But I will have a pina.
Yeah.
Colata.
Get a peener, dude. They're different. We'll be right back.